iPhone 16, Galaxy S24, and Pixel 9 are the most popular compact flagship phones of 2024, and they come with four chipsets. The Galaxy S24 has an Exynos 2400 and a Snapdragon 8 Gen 3 variant. The iPhone has A18, the latest Apple Silicon chipset. The Pixel 9 has the latest Tensor G4 from Google, produced in Samsung Foundry. In this video, we'll compare the battery life, efficiency, and power of these four devices. I set all phones to the same 700 nits brightness, connected them to the same 5G network with four SIM cards, and used the same setting, such as turning off the speakers. I am not a scientist. I teach A/B testing and data science at university, and I do my best to stay impartial in this video. I disconnected all phones from Wi-Fi and connected to the 5G network. From left to right, you can see the Galaxy S24 Exynos, the Galaxy S24 Snapdragon, the iPhone 16 base model, and then Pixel 9. I got many comments that the bezels of our S24 SD are bigger. The reason that you think that is that the color of the Snapdragon variant is black, so it gives you an illusion that the bezels are bigger, but they are not. I'm running the Android app that I wrote to measure battery life and battery temperature, but the app is only for Android. Hence, I will just magnify the battery percentage on the iPhone. I started a test by running YouTube videos, and I set them all to run on 480p, so as not to run out of data. Some people may think YouTube is consuming a lot of power, but actually, all social media content are among the least power-hungry apps. One thing I should mention about the display is that both S24 run LTPO in 120Hz, which means the refresh rate is variable, while iPhone 16 runs 60Hz constant, and Pixel 9 is running 120Hz constant. By the end of this part of the test, the Galaxy S24 Exynos has 88% battery left, the Galaxy S24 Snapdragon had 91% battery left, the iPhone had 88%, and finally, the Pixel had 87%. iPhone 16 and Pixel 9 were the hottest and had a similar temperature, while Galaxy S24 Exynos was 1 degree cooler than them, and Galaxy S24 Snapdragon was 2 degrees Celsius cooler than them. For the second part of the test, I ran the camera to record 4K at 60 frames per second. iPhone increased the brightness of the screen by quite a lot during this test in the beginning, but I didn't touch anything. This test ran for 35 minutes, and by the end of it, iPhone 16 was the coolest. Then Pixel 9 and Galaxy S24 Snapdragon came second. And finally, Exynos was the hottest phone, but I don't mean it in a good way. Battery, the S24 Exynos was 72%, the S24 Snapdragon was 77%, the iPhone 16 was at 74%, and finally, the Pixel 9 was at 73%. So far, the difference is not huge. Before we move to the performance test, let's talk about Ugreen and the Ugreen Uno series, the sponsor of today's video. Ugreen Uno 100W charger has a goofy, groovy robot design that shows the status of charging of your phone. For example, the smiley changes based on whether your phone is connected, charging, or already fully charged. It is 100 watts, has 4 ports, and can charge iPhone 16 from 0 to 57% in only 30 minutes. You can attach up to 4 devices to the charger, basically all devices in this test. Here I'm charging 2 phones plus my MacBook Pro. Also, since it has built-in thermal guard, it protects your devices from overheating, overcharging, and excessive current. All the phones in this video also support wireless charging, and Ugreen also has you covered with the Uno 2-in-1 magnetic wireless 15W charger. It also shows you, based on cute emojis, how your phone's charging status is going. You can attach your phone and put it on a nice angle by rotating the top of the charger, and simultaneously, you can charge another phone using the USB-C charger. Ugreen Uno series has many other products like this hub that I'm using to connect USB devices to my MacBook. They have a power bank, cute little cables with emojis that I love, and lots of other things. They are fast and fun charging accessories for your iPhone. I put the link of these devices in the description. Thanks to Ugreen for sponsoring this video. We then move into performance testing. I will start with AnTuTu test. Some folks think benchmarks should be kept out of the battery test. I kind of agree because the result may skew towards the less powerful chipset. On the other hand, I could play some video games and that could have had the same effect. In general, the more powerful the chipset, the more power-hungry it is. Also, except for Pixel 9, the rest is very on par performance-wise. By the time the AnTuTu test was finished, S24 Snapdragon had won 1.7 million, followed by 1.67 million from iPhone 16, then 1.63 million by Sony for Xness, and finally Pixel 9 had a disappointing 1.08 million. Also, one thing to note is that depending on the situation, you can get different results. For example, last time I ran the benchmark on my table on balcony, the S24 Xness got a better score than the iPhone 16, probably because the outdoor weather helped it to cool down. Then I ran the stress test with 3DMark. This test runs a loop 20 times to put the GPU under stress to see how the sustained performance is for the phones. In this test, two scores are more important, the first loop and the last loop. The first loop shows the peak performance. Here the S24 Xness got 4K, then the S24 Snapdragon got the best score with 4.9K, the iPhone 16 got a similar score of 4K to Xness, and finally Pixel only got 2.5K. For the last loop, Xness got 2K, Snapdragon got 2.2K, iPhone with A18 got 2.5K, which is the best, and it means the thermals are being managed better, and finally Tensor got 1.6K. Also, battery-wise, the S24 Xness is at 46%, the S24 Snapdragon is at 55%, the iPhone 16 is at 51%, and the Pixel 9 is at 54% left. As I said, since Pixel is less powerful, it has a bit of an advantage battery-wise in this portion of the test. After this test, I ran the Aquarium WebGL, which puts the phones under stress in the browser. I changed the number of fish so that all of them run a similar frame rate, so it does not give an unfair advantage to a specific chipset. Interestingly, in this specific test, it was the iPhone 16 that started to go to throttling first and dim the screen. On the other hand, the iPhone was also the only one that kept the 60 frames per second, while both S24 got to around 40 and Pixel got to 33 frames per second. By the end of the test, the S24 Xness got to 40%, the S24 Snapdragon got to 50%, the iPhone 16 got to 41%, and Pixel 9 got to 49%. Then I turned off the phones and went to sleep. When I woke up the next day, S24 Xness lost 7%, Snapdragon lost 6%, iPhone lost 9%, and Pixel lost 5%. Just a side note, the phones usually don't lose so much during a standby. The reason the numbers are higher than usual is that they were uploading the video that we took earlier in Google Photos, and since they are connected to 5G, they are consuming more power uploading a 30 minutes 4K video. Now it's time to outdoor test. I ran Komoot on all four phones and decided to go for a walk and do groceries while being connected to GPS. It was the start of autumn in Vienna and it was rainy. I also wonder why this driver thought I was walking with four phones in my hand and crossing the street. By the time I was back, S24 Xness got to 21%, Snapdragon to 34%, iPhone got to 17%, and Pixel 9 got to 29%. For the last part of the test, I installed and ran Google Meet on all four phones. This is one of the most, if not the most intense test of all. Uploading a video and then downloading multiple while encoding and decoding them and capturing it all at the same time. Right now, the S24 Xness got to 12%, the Snapdragon to 27%, which is insane, the iPhone 16 got to 9%, and it seems it is the first one that is going to leave the chat, and Pixel 9 to 20%. Also, Pixel disconnected itself from 5G and connected to 4G. I don't know how to turn off the setting so it does not forcefully disconnect from 5G when it goes below 20%. Let me know if you know the trick. Even though it did look like at the beginning that the iPhone was going to die first, the S24 Xness surprised us all by draining rapidly during this part of the test while burning super hot at 48 degrees Celsius and 118 Fahrenheit. Also, it did disconnect itself from the rest of the pack and could not keep the connection, probably due to overheating and other issues. So even though I know some of you were rooting for it not to die first, unfortunately, it left the chat first with 4 hours and 38 minutes screen on time. iPhone kept the final 1% very well and it died at 4 hours and 44 minutes, which is only a few minutes more than S24 Xness. Now, there are only 2 contestants on the battlefield. I also started to run YouTube in the background while having a video call between these two phones. At this point, it is very obvious that the S24 Snapdragon is going to win the battle despite having a much smaller battery capacity compared to Pixel 9 and a much more powerful chipset than all of the others. Pixel 9 finally left the chat at 5 hours and 13 minutes, which is almost half an hour more than the iPhone 16. Galaxy S24 Snapdragon kept it very well for another few minutes and died 5 minutes after Pixel 9 with 5 hours and 18 minutes screen on time, which is impressive considering the sibling S24 Exynos was the first to go. The final result is ready. In the last place, we have the Samsung Galaxy S24 Exynos with 4 hours and 38 screen on time. Even though it did better than Pixel 9 in terms of performance, it was behind the S24 Snapdragon and was almost on par with iPhone 16. The other problem was that the overheating was more severe and we started to encounter connection issues towards the end of the video when the phone started to overheat. By the way, I'm using One UI 6.11 for both S24s. The third place is the iPhone 16 with 4 hours and 44 screen on time. I expected a better result considering the phone has only 60Hz display, but on the other hand, this year, the iPhone has a performance drop compared to previous generation, and also the phone kept relatively cool during the test. If you're an iPhone user, I think it is a decent option to buy. The second place was Google Pixel 9. Pixel 9 is the biggest of the batch and is noticeably heavier than the rest because of its bigger battery capacity. The phone has a disappointing performance both for graphics and CPU. Tensor is a cousin to Exynos, but with fewer cores. That said, Pixel 9 stayed relatively okay from a thermal perspective, and the battery also lasted more than S24 Exynos and iPhone 16. In the first place, we have the S24 Snapdragon, which has wiped the floor with its excellent performance, super battery life, and very acceptable thermals. Definitely in compact phones, the Snapdragon 8 Generation 3 currently is the best option overall. And if you're in a market where the S24 Snapdragon is available, it is no-brainer to get it. In this test, I also included benchmarks that can skew the battery results a bit, but I also did a day-in-the-life comparison between iPhone 16 and Galaxy S24, which you can watch next. Thanks for tuning into Tecmo, and I will see you in the next one.